Hey everyone, I'm Ultima 456, you're the Ultimates, and welcome to episode 67 of Let's Platinum Danganronpa 2, Goodbye Despair. Alright, who is it? We know a few things. The video was live. It was recorded in the conference room. As soon as Hajime saw it, he left the hospital and ran to the music venue where Ibuki was already killed. It wasn't Ibuki that he saw in the video, and it could have only been one person. And that person was you, Mikan Sumiki.
You're the only one! Mikan, you're the killer, aren't you?
What are you talking about?
Like I said, aren't you the killer who murdered Ibuki and Hyoko?
Killer? Huh? I'm the killer? What is this?
Hey, don't you think that's kinda impossible? A chick like her as the killer? She couldn't even kill a fly. In fact, the fly would probably kill her first.
She's right! A clumsy slowpoke like me killing someone? That's completely out of the question!
But we're the only ones. Thanks to that video, we're the only ones who have the advantage of an alibi.
An alibi? Was that the killer's goal?
Now that you mention it, you guys brought that up earlier. Only Hajime and Mikan have an alibi.
It's just a coincidence!
But you're the only one who could have filmed that video in the hospital conference room. Is that also a coincidence?
Alright, so this part is very clever as well. Hajime says, shouldn't you get some rest already? You should be exhausted from nursing without any sleep, right? And then Mikan says, then if you insist, I will use the on-call room upstairs. You must be mentally exhausted, so it's better if you relax in the lobby instead. It was kind of subtle, but that was pretty much the first time that Mikan's ever been sort of confident and told someone what to do, you know, or at least heavily suggested what to do. And then Hajime agreed and went there.
At that time, you said you were going to the on-call room, but you actually went to the conference room,
which is right next door.
That's when you put on a hospital gown that you prepared in advance, put the bag on your head, and began filming. By doing that, you made up a video that showed Ibuki trying to hang herself at the music venue. And showed that to me. Furthermore, I saw that video at the hospital lobby. If someone wants to go to the conference room from outside, they have to pass through the lobby.
So it's impossible that someone who wasn't already in the hospital went to the conference room to film.
Mm-hmm.
Not only that, the others in the hospital, Akane and I, were both delirious from the despair disease.
So that must mean...
Please, wait a second! What are you saying? I'm the killer! That's impossible! There's no way I could kill someone!
It's not literally impossible. Can't you give a better defense than that?
She shows she can't even do that.
Hey, you sure this chick is really the killer?
Wrong! It's totally wrong! It's not what you think!
Just like Akane said, it is really hard to tie it all together. I mean, Mikan is the killer?
I agree. It is truly difficult to believe someone could be killed by such a slow-witted woman.
That slow-witted remark is not necessary.
It's fine. I've been like this for a long time. In a tournament for social punching bags, I'd easily win first place with my soft reputation. Even I can't deny that. How many times do I have to tell you? It's impossible for me to kill someone! I'm serious! Very serious!
What do you say, Hajime?
Do you still believe this woman is the killer?
Do you hate me that much, Hajime?
Hey, Hajime!
Wow. Everyone's ganging up on me. Tr- tricks aside, logic aside, is she really capable of doing something like this? Could it be? I'm the one making a mistake? No. In fact, it'd be so much easier if I was wrong. If I have this much doubt about someone I've spent so much time with...
Can you hold on a minute?
Huh?
Well, I know I'm being intrusive and all, and I mean, I have no place to say this. I missed all of the critical parts, and I doubt I have anything worth saying at an important time like this.
What are you saying?
But still, there's definitely no way I can overlook the killer this time.
Huh?
I thought it was suspicious all along, from the very beginning. Investigating with a suspect in mind creates a different result than investigating with no leads.
Hey, what are you trying to say?
Well, thanks to that, I was able to discover a truth that nobody else knows.
What? Are you serious?
I've been so focused on everybody else this trial. But I guess now's a good time to say it, right?
You better not have kept quiet on purpose. This isn't a game, you know!
Actually, this is a game!
Please don't say such controversial statements!
Well, what do you know, Nagito?
Well, it's nothing big, really. Only a small, decisive clue that points to the killer.
Dang! That's a huge deal!
A decisive clue? Does something like that really exist?
Let's take a look, shall we? Regarding the rope Ibuki was dangling from...
Yes, this came up in the investigation very early and Nagato said something about it. Let's find out what he was talking about.
This rope was supplied by the supermarket, right? There weren't any ropes inside the music venue.
Again with the supermarket? That place is a hotspot for criminal goods.
If they got it at the supermarket, that means it was brand new, right?
What's wrong with that?
I want you to take a close look at this rope, and keep in mind that it's brand new. Near the middle of the rope, it's frayed, as if it was rubbed strongly. But why is it like this? The loop Ibuki used to hang herself is on one end of the rope, and the part of the rope that hung from the baton lighting is on the other end.
Hey, you're taking too long. What's wrong with the rope being frayed?
It means, well, from what I can infer, I think the rope was used like this. The killer wrapped the rope around Ibuki's neck, pulled both ends at full strength, and strangled her. The center of the rope is frayed because that's the part they used to strangle Ibuki.
Hold on. I've been listening to you for a while, and it sounds like you knew about this rope clue all along. What exactly did you say to me during the investigation?
So this rope won't be much of a clue. Then I might as well search another place.
Not everyone cooperates at a class trial. Those who lie and conceal the truth will obviously be here too. Just like this case's killer. I was just copying them a little bit.
Huh?
More importantly, what was all that about the rope? The killer strangled Ibuki. And then?
And then, I finished speaking.
Huh? How is that a decisive clue?
Huh? You didn't notice it. I thought I made the decisive clue very clear.
Nagito's words contain a decisive clue. Is that really true? Alright, now this one's tricky. I'm gonna do it and I'm gonna like read it for myself and try and work out what's going on.
Ibuki didn't die from hanging. She was strangled to death.
That's basically the same thing.
That's what I thought too.
Though hanging and strangling seem similar, they're very different. The scars they leave would look different too.
Scars? You mean the rope burn, right?
But we believed it was from a hanging. Why would that be?
Did we fall for someone's lie?
The body at the crime scene was hanged, you know. Obviously, we'd assume it was a hanging.
The Monokuma file complicates this too. It never specified hanging or strangulation.
Whoever misunderstood is to blame!
Okay. Ibuki's true cause of death was strangulation. That fact is the decisive proof that will lead to the killer. Is that true? Alright.
Ibuki didn't die from hanging, so she was strangled to
it's
death.
It's confusing because I actually thought...
That's basically the same
thing.
Yeah,
I thought it was the same
though
thing.
Hanging and strangling seem similar, the scars they leave would look different too.
Like if you're hung...
Scars? You mean the rope burn, right?
But we believed it was from a hanging. Why would that be?
Did we fall for someone's lie?
Got it.
That must be it!
I thought, like, if you're hung, your windpipe is constricted.
So that's what happened. We've been falling for the killer's lie this whole time.
If you're hung, your windpipe is constricted. If you're strangled, isn't that the same thing? Your windpipe is also constricted. It's just different intensity, I guess. But let's see how they explain it. So that's what happened. We've been falling for the killer's lie this whole time.
There's something I want to ask you. There's no doubt Ibuki's cause of death was being hanged by this rope, right?
Yes, she had no other external injuries, so there's no doubt she died from hanging herself.
I see, I see. So Ibuki died by hanging herself.
You said Ibuki hanged herself, but that was a complete lie, wasn't it, Mikan?
Okay, so Nagito asked that question to see what Mikan would say, and based on his assumption of what happened, Mikan lied, which had a very big impact on how Nagito thought about the case, and then he basically used her as the main, you know, she's the one that did it, so I'm going to find all these clues to point to her, basically. And he made a good point earlier where if you have someone that you're targeting, then your investigation is going to be aimed at that person, as opposed to if you're just trying to look at the clues objectively and work out the killer from there. You said Ibuki hanged herself, but that was a complete lie, wasn't it, Mikan?
You told us the wrong cause of death. You lied, didn't you? You should have been able to tell the difference between hanging and strangling just by looking.
I guess, like, yeah, that makes sense. Like, it would leave a different scar, or like they said, rope burn and all that, but in terms of the actual difference, I don't know.
You, Mikan, the ultimate nurse.
Mm-hmm. That is a good point. She's the ultimate nurse, not the ultimate doctor. They have medical training, but not to the extent that, like, a doctor or a surgeon would have, or a coroner for that matter.
That's why it's not my fault if I made a mistake.
You are right. And you have been a great help to us so far.
But even a drunk medical student can notice the difference between a hanging and strangulation.
Okay.
I'm not taking her side or anything, but being clumsy and unskilled in this area could lead to a mistake.
He's totally right! I'm such a clumsy mess, and I got so careless!
Mikan nursed me till I got better. There's no way I'm gonna doubt her.
Don't you think her devotion to nursing is what helped her draw Ibuki to her death?
Huh?
And if not, her symptoms were still very serious and caused her to believe what anybody told her. It wouldn't surprise me if she willingly followed Mikan because she was nursing her.
So Mikan volunteered to nurse us? Because she was planning to do this all along?
That's a little... Aren't you like the thief who suspects everyone else of being thieves?
I'm not a criminal. Mikan is. I mean, she's a killer, you know.
You've got it all wrong! Please forgive me!
I'm sorry, but there's no way I can forgive you. I just can't forgive this crime at all.
Forgiveness or not, we still have not decided if Mikan is the killer.
I see. You guys are kind. Well, if that's the choice everyone makes, then the only thing I can do is back off, I guess. But is that really okay? Is that everyone's hope?
You're friggin' annoying! If you keep talking, I'm seriously gonna beat you up!
But I'm really, really not the killer! There's no way I'm capable of killing someone!
Is that really true?
Stop it already! That's enough!
I can't stop! I don't want to do this either! Of course I don't want to do this! But I need to do this!
You doubt your friends?
That's not it! I suspect them because I want to believe them!
What the hell does that mean?
I don't think belief and doubt are necessarily opposites.
Huh?
I do doubt her. But I still want to believe her. Belief lies at the heart of that conflict. 'Cause if there's no room for doubt, then there's no reason to believe, is there?
Don't say deep stuff. I don't really get it.
If there's no room for doubt, then there's no reason to believe. It's a pretty good line, actually.
If you want to believe in someone, you need to overcome doubt first. Belief without doubt is simply a lie.
Fine. Do whatever you want. I won't stop you anymore.
Huh? Is that all you can say?
Ooh.
Ah, so in the end, you're all just a bunch of bullies, huh?
Voice change, animation change, awesome.
Justifying your actions with fancy words. Making excuses for why it's not really your fault. Everyone always treats me like that. Always. It's all her fault. She's the one with the problem. I'm done with that! You hear me? I'm done!
Hey, Mikan!
It's not fair. It's not fair. 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 Not fair! Why won't you forgive me? If you did something wrong, you'd forgive yourself right away! What did I do? Why won't anybody forgive me?
Is acting like this your strategy now? Well, this is annoying. Plus, to be honest, I've run out of ideas. How can we get you to admit it? That's the issue.
If we don't have any clues, why don't we have her give us some?
Huh?
I'm the same as Hajime. I don't want to doubt any of my friends. But still, the truth is one of us murdered two of our friends. That's why we gotta stick with this until the very end, so we can finally break these chains of despair.
Chiaki.
Hey, Mikan. Can I ask you one last thing? If you're not the killer, then who fabricated that video Hajime watched?
Like I said, it obviously wasn't me!
Can you prove it?
Prove it? Wait! Do you have any proof that I'm the one who fabricated that video? That's right! Show me your proof! Because you're just assuming the video was filmed at the conference room. Treating me like a killer based on an assumption. Just because I was at the hospital. That's totally crazy. I didn't do anything wrong. Why does everybody always hate me? Please. Just forgive me already.
Is this broad really okay? She's emotionally unstable.
I'm not the killer. That video. I never filmed that video!
It seems she finally started arguing for us.
Huh?
But the only one who can find the hole in her argument is you, Hajime. So, I'm going to leave this to you once again.
Could it be? Was this Chucky's goal all along? She's saying everyone's fate depends on me. The only person who saw that video.
Why do you get to decide I'm the killer? Where's your proof? Please, forgive me already!
I need to make up my mind. I'm the one who has to do it. I'm the one who's going to finish this. Let's do that next time. I want to thank you all for watching episode 67 of Let's Platinum Danganronpa 2 Goodbye Despair. My name's Ultima456, you're the Ultimates, and I'll see you next time.